So I just hit level 70 range. The experience rates with black gens are so much better. I used 1.1k black gens, got 192k experience at 308k experience per hour. So I'll be using black gens from now on to that 75 range and 70 defense goal. But I have to switch up my range gear to the 70 range stuff. So I just finished my first trip chinning defense. I got around 100k defense experience per hour and 100k range experience an hour. In total, I stayed there for around 50 minutes and it cost me a bit over 4 mil. So in chins, so this shit is expensive as fuck, but I'll keep doing it until I reach 70 defense. I just finished another trip at chinning. I got to 59 defense and 72 range, used around 1.5k black chins, I started with 2k, and gained about 108k defense and 100k range experience. So I just finished my third trip chinning defense, got up to 63, used around 1.6k black chins, got around 114k defense experience per hour. In total, I gained 130k defense experience. So in total, I have three trips left until I'm at 70 defense, and then I can finally buy myself the Rigor Scroll to unlock Rigor. Since I just passed 60 defense at my last chinning trip, I upgraded to an Odium Ward, which is a 5 more range bonus over a black DI shield. And I also upgraded to a 3rd age range coif, which is 1 extra range bonus over a Robin Hood hat, which I actually did not know up to today. And also the 3rd age top and bottoms are exactly the same range accuracy as the Gutix Dragonhide, so they aren't worth buying. Since the Gutix Dragonhide actually provides some prayer bonus, and as far as I know, 3rd age doesn't provide any. At least the coif doesn't, so I assume the rest of the range gear doesn't as well. So let's get back to chinning in my new fancy gear. So I just finished another chinning trip, got to 66 defense and 75 range. 75 range is really nice because I now could use a blowpipe, but I will still chin the defense to 70. Used about 1.6k chins again. 1.6k chins is around 4.5 mil. So I got 120k defense, 120k range per hour, about 136 in this trip. So that's nice. So I think two more trips and I will be done with the defense chinning. Just finished my fifth trip chinning defense. Had to stop a little bit early, but I gained around 120k experience, so only 100k left to level 70 defense. Used around 1.4k chins this time, so another 1.2k chins should bring me to level 70. I just got to 70 defense, and now rates were similar to before, used around 1.3k more black chins. Now, currently I'm at 81 combat, I need 85 to use Neve for the 69 Slayer. So I'll get the better gear from my main, buy the Rigor Scroll and summarize how many chins I used so far, so I can estimate how much money I'm throwing at this account. So right here, you can see my current stats. I'm 76 range, 70 defense, 75 prayer. I started the account about 46 hours ago and played probably around 20 hours on it so far. And I spent 1.6 mil on gray chins, 6.5 on reds, 29 mil on black chins, about 4 mil on potions I already used, and also spent 10.6 mil on prayer. I also just bought this prayer scroll for 82.25 mil, which is quite a lot. I'm not counting the gear currently, but in total on the account I have spent 134 mil so far. And now I can use Rigor. This is fucking amazing, bro. Amazing. And of course I also have to unlock Preserve. Now I can also use Preserve. Still have to do the quests for Piety and Chivalry. But since I'm not going for melee currently, they don't really matter. So, in total, already 134 mil spent. We'll do some more chinning now in my new upgraded gear. So, this will be my gear, plus black chins, of course. So, like this, I'm going to do some more chinning for some more combat levels, and then I'm doing some more nightmare zone to reach 85. I'm a retard. I just died with 1.3k black chins because I didn't look at my screen. So good fight. 4 mil, I would say. Yeah, money down the drain. XP rate was quite good. A bit over 300k an hour at that trip. Gained around 128k. I think I'll do something else in chinning for some time. So since I need a Avis accumulator, I had to get 35 foot cutting. And since I want to do some Nightmare Zone, I had to get 36 to be able to do Lost City for the boss in Nightmare Zone. Though this took me a little bit less than 2 hours, but I went to eat something. So I think 36 foot cutting should be done in around 1 hour and 10 minutes, probably, if you're looking at your screen actively. There's some quests that you could do, but I was not motivated to do any quests right now. I think Monk's Friend gives some woodcutting experience if you want to speed this process up. So now it's time for the crafting training. I just got 54 crafting. I mainly did jewelry. To be honest, I only cut stuff. I cut all the uncut stuff I could do and always did the best thing I could. And in total I spent 1.4 million on level 54. And the reason I got 54 is because at 54 you can start with battle staffs, and those are a lot cheaper and a more efficient or overall better way to train the skill. So I'll switch over to battle staffs. And my end goal is level 70 for Monkey Madness 2. And I just want to get those buyables done now. So I just finished the level 70 crafting grind for Monkey Madness 2. So this took about 3 hours, I would say. I did a lot of breaks, but from level 1 to 70 should be possible in about 3 to 4 hours. Or something around that, probably faster if you're not as AFK as I was. The whole thing cost me 4.2 mil from level 1 to 70. So that's nice. Now I'll get going and get like 20 Slayer so I can get the Avis accumulator. So I just got 19 Slayer. Was really fast, like 20k an hour. So I was here for about 5-10 minutes. Something around there. So that's nice. So I'll get Animal Magnetism done now. So I just finished Animal Magnetism. And now I have a lot of Avas, which is cool. So I could go to Nightmare Zone. But for Nightmare Zone, I need some more bosses unlocked. And since I don't want to do Fight Arena, because if I do Fight Arena, I can't stay a 50 attack piety build, and I'm not sure if I want to stay 50 attack, so I'm not going to do Fight Arena. Because of that, I'm doing some other quests, which I actually need in the future, which give you some bosses as well. So I just did Troll Stronghold, and before that I did Lost City, and I think now I have enough bosses to do some Nightmare Zone for my points I need for my imbued Black Mask and my imbued Archer Ring. So I'll go do that now. So for everyone interested, my NMC runs will be with those 5 bosses. So the basic ones, every pure uses and that. And my gear is this one. I just realized I forgot my Ranger boots, so I'll go get them in my bank. So I just finished a short round of Nightmare Zone. And the important thing is that you switch to a super range potion as fast as possible. So buy yourself some and get back in there with the super range potions if you're doing that, because they are a lot better than the standard ones. So I just finished my first Nightmare Zone run. I got 257k Nightmare Zone points. And 85k range experience. So the XP per hour was 97k in range and 32k in HP. So it's a quite okay training method. So I'll keep doing this until I have 1900 total Nightmare Zone points, so I can imbue my Archer Ring and my Black Mask, so I can start with Slayer. So I just approximated that, and I think this will take me around 6 hours, so probably I will be done with it tomorrow at some time. But this is everything in this video, so I hope you enjoyed it and you like those progress videos. So those are my current stats. I started the account 4 days ago, no, 3 days ago on Sunday evening. So those are my stats after 3 full days and playing quite a lot, but not all the time. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like, leave a comment, join my CC. It's Michael's First. There are actually some people here, 3 times me and 3 other guys. Really cool. We chat a bit. Nice. Thanks for watching and bye.